Hi, welcome back to Review. A drilling operation tunneling through the mountains of Davao results in an eruption and the deaths of several workers and protesters. The Norwegian government, which is in dire need of solutions, enlists a wide range of scientists, among them Nora, a paleontologist who has just made a significant discovery. Only Nora and the advisor to the Prime Minister, Andreas Isaksen, point out that the area is surrounded by sizable impressions that resemble footprints. The scientists in attendance initially think that the eruption was brought on by the miners striking a pocket of methane. When a second incident miles away destroys the home of an elderly couple, the Prime Minister allows them to look into the possibility with Norwegian military soldier, Captain Chris Holm. The three turn to Tobias for help after Nora starts to suspect that a troll might be to blame. Tobias has since lost his professorship due to his conviction that mythical creatures have a real origin. The four unintentionally awaken the sleeping troll, which had hidden itself on the mountainside, after Tobias spots a topographical anomaly following a quick search of the mountains. As they flee, they record the first concrete video evidence of Nora's theory. The Prime Minister organizes a military operation under the command of Chris, but the troll is only irritated by conventional weapons. When the troll is startled by additional gunfire, Tobias is killed after making an attempt to communicate with it. Nora suggests a sonic attack using church bells based on her research into the mythology, but it enrages the creature rather than incapacitating it and results in significant collateral damage. International news organizations take up the story and broadcast it globally after the rampage. The Prime Minister issues a complete city evacuation order as the troll approaches Oslo, the capital of Norway. Nora and Andreas object to the government's plan to drop a nuclear bomb on Oslo to kill the troll, but they are kicked off the task force. Nora makes one final effort to learn more about the creature. The royal palace is where they find Rikard Sinding, chief of court, who tells them the truth about trolls in Norway after being guided there by Tobias Notes. Trolls had been residing in Norway before being exterminated by Christian settlers, and Tobias had been right all along. The truth had been hidden in folklore. Sinding had Nora's father discredited and committed to a mental hospital when he came too close to the truth. After the Christians killed his family and left him for dead in a cavern in the Davao Mountains, the Troll King's palace was destroyed and the royal palace was erected on top of it. Nora deduces that the creature is making its way toward Oslo in an effort to get back home. The troll will be exposed to UV light from several tanning beds after Nora and Chris learn that trolls are sensitive to direct sunlight. Andreas asks his friend Sigurd to stop the bombing of Oslo while Chris asks his fellow soldiers to construct the troll trap at the covert government facility. To stop the nuclear attack, Sigurd hacks into the military's computer system. The troll is lured to the UV light trap by Nora and Andreas, who put the skull of one of the troll's babies in the back of the Queen's truck. In the end, Nora suddenly changes her mind. She turns out the lights and makes an effort to save the creature. However, the sun then rises into a clear sky and kills the troll. This has been one of the few surprises for this year, and in my opinion, it even beats the major blockbusters. It's a good watch and very enjoyable. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.